everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm giving you all a studio tour. I've been wanting to shoot a studio tour for a while now and I'm really happy to show you all what I have in my space. So without further delay, let's get right to it. So if you watched my studio transformation video, you might be aware that this is a bedroom studio. I live with my husband. This was our main bedroom. We live in a two-bedroom apartment. If you haven't watched the video, I'll link the video here so that you know how this room got curated. So before I show you guys around, I just wanted to mention that it's just been about 1 year since I started taking art more seriously. Sometime from January 2021 or December 2020 is when I actually started making art more seriously. The things that you'll see around here have been bought in the last 1 year. So I would say I'm still in the very beginning stages of my art journey. I've not really tried out a lot of fancy art supplies or tools or anything like that, but I think it's the journey that matters. Yeah, my intention with this video is to just share what I have as I'm in this journey. And that's all I wanted to add, so I think we can start with this space here. So this is basically my art section. If you've been watching my previous videos, you might notice that I do not really have this easel here. That's because I just bought it 2 days back. This is a 6 feet easel and I've placed this right next to the balcony. This is an east facing balcony, so we get really lovely sun rays, especially from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. There's like really beautiful sunlight coming in, and I love that about this room. I have shown you these ruffled curtains in my studio transformation video. I just absolutely love these curtains. I think they give such an amazing vibe to the room. I'm really happy that I've purchased them. I also have these lights. I don't know what they're called, and they give a really good ambience in the evenings especially. Here I have some creepers. They're not real. I wish they were, but I have some creepers just to add some greens here and to just tie everything together. Like, it just looks like one thing. Here is where I have most of my art supplies, at least the ones that I use very often. So this is a four-tier stand that I bought off Amazon, and I'd say it's like a cheap alternative to the IKEA trolley. I know that one looks really fancy, but it is a little expensive, and I thought that maybe I'll just try out a cheaper option for now. So the first section, I have all my paint brushes. I have all the fine brushes here. I have large brushes here and my fan brushes here. So these containers are actually coffee and tea containers that I bought a set of these from Reliance. And also I have some round pointed brushes here. So this is a pink one that I bought with my little dog is getting excited because she's confused, like, what's happening. Okay, sit. And I use again one of these containers, using it with the lid as a trash can. And it doesn't look like a trash can, but I use it like a trash can. Also, I have my water jar here. It's super dirty, so excuse that, please. I also have a plant here. This section is where I keep all my paints. So I primarily use acrylic paints. So I have all my acrylic paints in here, including my palettes, which are very dirty. I have a separate big container for white paint because we all know how important white is for us. The paints that I don't use very often, I keep them here in the last section. So I have my gouache here. Then I have neon liners, charcoal willow, white charcoal pencil, materials that I don't really use that often. My Camel inks here. Down here I have some stationery stuff, mostly tapes, corner puncher, punch holding. Here I have my canvas rolls and I keep them all in this basket. This is actually a plant basket, but I don't have this bigger pot to use this. So I thought, why not use it as storage thing for my rolls and canvas rolls and larger papers. So that's that. Now let's move to the table side. Okay, so coming to this side of the space, I'd say this is like the highlight wall of the studio. I've attached a metal grid mesh in the center. I call this like my inspiration space. So this is an artwork that I have done, but like these are just inspirations because I've been trying to learn more about the different kind of plants and flowers, and I barely remember their names. So I really wanted to have some of their plants, and the names are written down here. These are just printouts from Pinterest that I really liked, like the botanical plants that I really liked. I love this kind of illustrative style, so I just want to have it in front of me so that I get inspired every time I see them. Also, I have some Pantone cards here. Anytime I feel inspired by a certain kind of color palette, I kind of like to have these cards together to see how the colors look against each other, and I felt like it fit really well with this inspiration board thing. This is like a small tag that I have made, do all things with love, and that's something I really believe in, and I wanted to put that out here. This is a glass frame. So if you've watched my studio transformation video, you have seen this. I put a fresh flower, I put fresh flower in between, and I think it looks so pretty and minimal. I really love this here. This one is an illustration that I had done some time back. I just really love the style, the illustration, the colors, so I really want to hang it right here in the center. This frame here is a print of one of my artworks which I had done long back. I put a different quote for every week. So this week I have Shine Your Light, just something to look at and feel good and motivated. So yeah, I keep it here. And I have this scented candle. I just love this one. This was gifted to me by my dearest friend Senjuti. So thank you, Senju. It's almost over. I light it almost every day because it really sets the mood to paint, to create. The smell is just amazing. Here I have a creeper plant. I think this one's called philodendron. I'm really hoping that this kind of grows along the edge of this arch, and I bought this when it was really tiny, and I'm really happy how it's growing. I did propagate this plant here, so this is also growing. I need to repot this soon because the roots are quite long now. Another small plant, it's kind of dying, but I'm trying to get it back. And this table is an IKEA table. This is the multi-purpose IKEA table. I love this table. I really wanted a minimal table with a large surface to work, and this is perfect for that, so I really love this table. If you see this top section here, I have a floating rack, and I have some small things here, a candle and just small things that I never use at all. And that's a tree branch, just wrapped some leaves around it, and I've hung that there. And this side, I have some of my artworks. I have these pretty creepers. So now that we are done with this space, let's move to this space. So also I forgot to mention the chair. This is also from IKEA, and I got it from Amazon only, but this is an IKEA chair. So here I have a floor lamp. This kind of acts like a nice separation between both the spaces, and also I like to have some kind of light when I'm working at night time or evenings. I have this beautiful bamboo plant here. I have another plant here. I've not really done much on this wall. I just wanted to keep it a little simple. I have two of my really old artworks here, but I wanted to bring in some yellow, that kind of summery vibe, and put them out here. And then I have that little DIY thing that I had made. If you watched my transformation video, you might have seen how I made that. So this table is a part of this apartment. When we moved in, we got two study tables like this. Only thing I changed is to add this laminate on top. So that's because I didn't want to dirty the tables, because obviously there's a lot of paint falling, there's resin falling. I mean, when I move out, I'll just peel it off and it should be fine. So here I have my tabletop easel, and I have the canvas that I painted last month, one of the older wood panels that I had painted on. So down here are my sketchbooks. I don't really own many sketchbooks. I own about 4 or 5 A5 sketchbooks, one pocket sketchbook, and for the bigger ones I use loose A3 size sheets. Behind here is where I keep all the rags hidden. So I keep it tucked away here, and whenever I need to use it, I just take it from behind here and use it, and I keep it back there so that the space does not look messy. Here I have stretched canvases. Some of them I have just sketched and really not started painting. Some are new, round ones, some small round ones, and just a storage space for my canvases. So this is actually the back side of the table. I've kind of put it the other way around because the other side of the table has drawers. And to be honest, I did not want to have the drawers on this side because I've noticed the more drawers I have, the more I tend to throw stuff in. So I wanted to avoid that, and I decided to have the drawers that side so that I'm not tempted to throw in stuff. Yeah, just wanted to mention that. In case you're wondering why there are no drawers here. Coming to this side, this is where I keep my spray cans, art resin here. I keep it this side so that it's away from sunlight and heat, because it does get really warm in here during summers. That's what I have here on this side. So these are just hardboards for me to stick larger sheets of canvas and stuff that I can use later. I just keep it all here. Okay, so we are done with this section. Moving to this section. Okay, now let's see what we have on this side. So this is the space where I do all my editing, emails, and everything to do with the computer. So this is also where I plan my week. I have this bulletin board here, which is like my planning board. I have a printout of the calendar there. This is also where I pin my weekly plan. I don't have it here right now because it wasn't really looking good. I use the same chair for both the sides. I really didn't want to crowd the space with two chairs. So anyways, it's just right opposite to these other sections, so I just use one chair. And around here I have some of my art prints up just to brighten up the space. This is the second table that we got when we moved in here. Here too I have laminated the top of the table. So here on top you'll see I have my ZZ plant here. I absolutely love this plant. Here I have two containers, the same one that I used that side. Just to keep pens. These are just literally just regular pens here. I don't really use a lot of pens for my artworks. I'm not really a sketcher. I don't really sketch as much as I would like to. I just own a couple of these graphic pens. Keep my white pens here. This is a little container that I painted. If you haven't watched that video where I paint containers, I'll link it up here and you can have a look. I have my daily planner. I have a little pocket notebook that I use often. Two hard disks that I use often. Let's move to this section here now. So this is a section that is not that organized. No matter how many times I organize this section, it always gets messed up. These are basically all the notebooks that I use on a daily basis. All of these are from my notebook collection. Don't get me wrong, it's not because I don't want to buy other notebooks. It's when I was getting the notebook sampling done, I did have a lot of notebooks. Some of them have defects, some are not the actual size, so I really couldn't do anything with them. So I'm just like kind of using all the notebooks that I can't sell. But I do love using notebooks. I keep a separate notebook for every aspect of my life. I'm using this metal stand to keep these organized. Behind here I have my Wacom tab. I have all my printing paper and sticker papers and things that I use for printing. I just keep it all at the back because I don't print daily, so I don't really need them right in front. Here I have stuff that I'm not really organized that well. Literally this is just full of a basket full of things. My DSLR camera, extra pair of spectacles here. There I keep my tripods, overhead tripod. Quite a messy section. So moving to this space, So my initial plan with this space was to have it as an inventory storage for my stationery and prints, for my store related stuff. That wasn't really working out because obviously to have all the stationery displayed means that it'll catch dust, and it was getting really difficult to maintain that. So I just use it as a showcase sort of a space now, but this is really a lot of space for that. So I'll just quickly show you guys what I have here. In the topmost section, I have some plants. Some of them have actually dried out because I'm not really able to take care of them since they are out of my reach. Second section, I have two books here that I was reading. This is my Polaroid camera that my husband gifted to me. Here I have this incense holder. But this is just my kneading eraser that I'm using as an incense holder. And here inside I have a candle. I have another candle here, a candle there. Something my cousin Meghna gave me. It's, I haven't charged it now, but it's like a fan and it's so cute. This is Alexa. Okay, sorry.
No worries.
In this third section here, I have some of my favorite books. I have my tarot and oracle cards. I have a mirror. I have this lovely Bible that my husband bought for me. And a candle, one more candle, some rocks that I had collected when I had gone for a walk, some pine cones, basically just a few things that I feel look good together. Now this section, I have my printer. I have some boxes where I have organized some of my, some random tapes, stamps, craftsy stuff like that. Has all my earring making tools. And then I have this this Pantone card book. It's, these are originally postcards if I'm not wrong. It's a wooden box. Inside I have some tassels and some just random yarn. Here I have two bottles that I painted. Here I have some books that I've been reading. And this is the weighing machine that I use for my store related stuff. Third, again I have these baskets where I have organized. So this one has my thank you cards, my business cards and other packaging stuff. In this I have all the clay, and these are some extra clay packets here. So I keep all the clay related stuff here. This section is also done, and if you see, this side is the bed. Side of the room generally is not seen in my videos, but let me show it to you all. I don't even keep a pillow on the bed because I don't want it to be a distraction for me where I just rest or just lie down. So I prefer not to keep anything on the bed. And that is a bathroom, and that's the entrance door. And yeah, this is the other space. So that's how the room gets completed. So that's what's there in my studio. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it gives some of you guys some ideas to set up your art space. Yeah, let me know in the comments what you thought about the video. If you liked the video, then please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, then please consider subscribing. Don't forget to hit the bell notification so that you get notified the next time I upload a video. Yeah, that's all I have for today. Sending you all lots of love and light, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye.